Hello everyone, welcome back again to JN Electric YouTube channel. Do you have this NAT3020i amplifier that I'm showing off? If you still have it, I will show you how to use it back and to fix it too. Also make sure the small LED light in front of the green panel is still on. If it doesn't light up, that is sign that the amplifier is a problem. There are two types of NPN and PNP transistors, R2N3055 and MJ2955. Also do test and checks for two capacitor, 47,000 microfarad electrolytic capacitor, which usually like to dry out and short circuit. The all electrolytic capacitor installed on the PCB so that this amplifier is of very good quality. Because the capacitor are usually very strong, the fields is yellow, orange and green. The NAT3020i is stereo integrated amplifier by NAT Electronic, considered to be one of the most important component of the history high fidelity audio. Launched in 1978, this highly affordable product delivery a good quality which a rich and reputation as the audiophile amplifier of exceptional value. And you should also check a stereo potentiometer that is on the front of this panel, often also has the rather bad and sound, or the potentiometer has broken. And also electrolytic capacitor usually have the degrees in value and their peak of often bubble. And also check the feeder cable, especially the solder under the PCB. Often it is disconnected or the solder is raw. If you are one of the amplifier user, this top should not be closed. This will experience air exchange in the panel box. No, this amplifier has been discontinued. Maybe you have or get from this second-hand item. It costs around $200 to up to $300. What you should pay attention to gain the testing and working on the transistor 2N3055 and MJ2955 transistor. This transistor tend to be damaged. It carries the heavy load, and also you have to check the gain of this transistor, or it can be said that it has the low and HFA better. You should also replace the trimmer potentiometer because it is very small and tends to be damaged and full of dust inside. Both of these transistors are of the PNP and NPN types. These are transistor for the input transistor output, and this transistor is often damaged because its job is very hard to fit the input transistor to be output. What is often damaged again is the bottom of the PCB, which may be chipped or crushed, or there may be a disconnected wire, so you check carefully using an ohmmeter. I've been accompanying you for 4 minutes. Hopefully this short video is useful for you, and thank you for watching.